And we're here at Giant Stadium, where close to 77,000 are in attendance for our upcoming game between Philadelphia and New York. We'll now go to Tom Hammond and Chris Collinsworth for our call. Guys?
With a beautiful day in the forecast, we'll get ready for today's game. Hi, everyone. Tom Hammond here, along with Chris Collinsworth. Chris, what are your thoughts on this rivalry game?
I talked to both of these coaches earlier in the week, and the funny thing is, every time I come out of a conversation with one coach, I'm sure that team's going to win, and then I go talk to the other coach, and I'm sure that team's going to win. So I basically don't know what's going to happen today.
Offset I formation in the backfield. Here's the give. What a hit. I don't think he even saw that guy. Nice job by the running back. That'll give him 7, maybe 8 yards. Jacobs is the single setback. Hands it off. Stiff arms, and the defender still makes the tackle. He really fought hard to get the first there.
If you're running back and your big offensive line keeps pounding those things in there like that, keep converting these first downs, it really starts to wear down a defense.
New 45! New 45! Friday, Friday, Friday!
First down, looking to throw. Throws it. Pass completed. Brought down at the 45. Everything seemed to work perfectly on that one.
And that's a pattern that this team likes to run. You know they've been studying that all week on film, and yet they still can't stop it.
They'll throw on first down with the hard throw out to his right. He's pushed out at the 31. A nice-looking play that time.
Yeah, when you see the blitz, you have to understand your own protections, because if your protection is sliding away from the blitz, you have no choice but to get it out of there to the hot receiver.
Manning drops back, passes to his right. Threw it right to him, but he can't hang on. An excellent job by the defense of disrupting that last play.
And that was really on the wide receiver. Not much of a route, very little separation, and gave the defense a chance to make that play.
Looks to pass. Rifles this one out to the middle. This one falls incomplete. No completion that time, and it'll bring up third down. It's third and 10. Ward, the lone back. Drops back. Strong throw to his right. And he's knocked out at the 15. A nice completion to the tight end.
I always thought tight ends were sort of like pacifiers for babies, you know? Just about the time that you need a little security blanket, you know where to go.
They hand it off again. Brought down at the 9. Jacobs gets 6 yards after taking the handoff on the counterplay. The backfield is in the offset I formation. New York uses motion. They'll go with a run once again. What a hit at the 10. Loss of 1 there for the halfback.
Boy, a shot like that, not only does it play well on television today, but tomorrow in that defensive film room, it's going to be even better.
They line up in the shotgun, 3 wide.
New 45!
Tennessee!
New 45!
Come on, y'all, lock those quick out! You got that?
Walk the hard, Charlie. Sets up the play action, and the defense has a heavy rush. And he's out of bounds, incomplete. They went with a sideline pass, but he couldn't stay in bounds.
And that would have been a spectacular catch if he'd been able to come up with that one, just thrown a little bit too far outside.
Kick is up. And he makes it. Nice work putting that one right through the upright. And now we'll take a quick look at the drive summary. And here's the kick. Taken from the 3-yard line. At the 30. Dropped at the 34-yard line. Now we'll see how the offense responds as they come onto the field for the first time.
All right, your defense just gave up a field goal, but that really doesn't change anything offensively. You come out, stick to your game plan, do exactly what you planned on doing here.
They'll throw on first down. Looks for a man open. The pass rush gets there, and he's down. They're going to have to figure out a way to block him, or he's going to keep getting back there.
You know, I couldn't agree more. This is one of those guys that's sneaky fast. Even when I watch him on tape, he looks fast and he looks talented, but then you see him in person, and all of a sudden, he's turning that corner so much faster. I think the same thing's happened to this offensive line. They weren't ready for this.
Smith was the intended receiver, but the pass fell incomplete. It's third and 15, ball on the 29-yard line. New York lines up in a dime defense here. Drops back to pass. Dumps it out left. Makes a cut, and he will be hit and dropped. Fourth down coming up as the offense goes three and out. Roca is the punter. Punts it. McQuarters takes it at the 25. The offense takes the field, hoping to come away with more than just a field goal on this drive. They'll take over at the 26-yard line. First down now and 10 to go. Tosses left. He's brought down around the 29-yard line. 3 yards on the run. It's second down and 7 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Give to the tailback. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. Jacobs picks up 2 yards with the carry. High formation here. Shockey takes off in motion. Looks to pass. On the run, he throws it. He's dropped in the open field. He gunned that one in there for the first down, didn't he?
He really did. And when you watch a guy throw a ball that hard, they don't move their arm any faster. You see him driving off that back leg. That was a pretty pass.
From their own 43-yard line. From the gun. Jacobs gets the call. He's tackled around the 47-yard line. He picks up 4 yards on the carry. The Giants line up in an I formation. He drops back to pass. He throws left. Makes the grab. And he's knocked out around the 35-yard line.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
And the defense gives up some 3 yards to the offense.
I always thought a defensive penalty was so much more deflating than an offensive penalty, because on offense you have a chance to make up for it. On defense, a lot of times it's big yardage and automatic first downs.
He drops back, looks down the field, and it's picked. He took a shot at the 19-yard line. Well, he looked like he was in the right place at the right time.
Unless you're the quarterback, then he was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
The backfield is in the offset I formation. Fakes to the back. Makes the catch. Let's head down to the field for the call.
Pass interference. Defense. The penalty is declined.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. McNabb is lined up under center. He has two backs behind him. He fakes it. Passes to his left. And he's out right around the 34-yard line. Nice job of shutting down the first down pass.
Yeah, it looked like that time the defense knew exactly what was coming. They were right there from the outset to make that play.
McNabb takes it back. Throws it short. Brought down at the 46-yard line.
You know, Donovan McNabb is really becoming much more of the classic drop back passer. Early in his career, he was a tremendous runner, wanted to get out. But now more and more, you're seeing him reading the defenses, making the clever little throws, and is so difficult to defend for a defense because he can still come busting out of there on the run.
Tackled at the 44-yard line. Nice pass play.
It really was in the 80s that we first started seeing offenses throwing the ball to the fullback. You know, for so many years, those guys were just big blockers.
Throws wild on the run. He's dropped at the 29-yard line.
I think Donovan McNabb can just make you look so bad at times. You know, he has the quick release. He gets the thing out of there. Sometimes he takes off with a run and makes you play sort of a spy situation against him. But then you forget how big an arm he really has. He has the ability to get the ball as far downfield as anybody in this league.
Second down now with 10 to go. And this is the eighth play of the drive. He's looking to throw. Not much time to throw. Westbrook has it go right through his hands. Not a good pass that time, Chris. He forced it right into the coverage.
Whoa, that was really lucky that one wasn't picked out. Not a good decision at all there.
Back to pass. Scans the field. Catch is made. He's tackled right around the 22-yard line. And that one was completed for a solid gain.
Solid gain, yes, but no first down on that play. So now it's going to bring up a decision on the part of the offense. Defensively, I think they executed that one exactly the way they wanted to.
The snap, set down, the kick is up. And we'll take a quick look at the drive summary. The kick. Fielded at the 4. Brought down at the 29-yard line. The quarterback leads his offense back onto the field after turning it over on their last drive. Manning to the air on first down. It's completed. Brought down at the 37. What an incredible throw into cover.
And we talk about all the strong-arm quarterbacks out there, but there aren't many of those guys that could have made that throw.
Manning doesn't like what he sees. They'll throw on first down. Dumps it out left. There for the catch. Gain of 4 on the pass.
Good job by the offense that time. Really nothing there down the field. He just takes a little completion and keeps moving the ball.
He's looking to throw. Surveys the field. Bradley intercepts it. And he probably should have never thrown the ball.
You know, Tom, there are some plays that their coaching staff will tell you, listen, we lost. You know, when you step back there and hit that back foot, we lost that play. Just don't make it a disaster. Throw that thing away.
Drops back on first down. Pass is complete. Tackled around the 38-yard line. Nice toss that time that'll get them a lot closer.
You know, there's really no doubting this quarterback's physical skills. Sometimes he struggles with his mechanics or accuracy, but I don't think that there's really any issue. This guy has the ability to be an elite quarterback.
He's tackled at about the 45-yard line. A decent gain on the pass.
And that's good quarterback play. He recognized the blitz. He understood what was happening with the coverage behind it and found the open man.
And they get him at the 49-yard line. Jackson picks up about 5 yards with the catch. They'll come out with 3 wide receivers. He fakes it. He needs to get the pass off. He's dropped around the 33-yard line. The defense was coming with a heat on that play.
But you never know it if you were watching the quarterback. He stood in there strong, completely relaxed, and made that defense pay that time.
McNabb has completed every pass on this drive. Caught out of bounds, incomplete. It looked like he tried to drag his feet as he was going out, but he couldn't get him down.
You know, and sometimes that happens. The quarterback put it in a spot where only he could catch it. The problem was the ball was just a little off target.
Back to throw. Goes through his read. Off target pass. Jackson was his intended target on that one, but they can't complete the pass. It's third down, 10 yards for a first. And this is the 8th play of the drive. He drops back to pass. Looks for a man open. It's incomplete. They were unable to convert on third and long, and you've got to think they'll go for 3 right now and kick the field goal.
Yeah, really nothing wrong with that pass. If it's not there, be safe with it. You know you got 3 points coming.
He gets it away. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The quarterback and his receiver were clearly not on the same page last time, and it led to an interception. And straight ahead we go with the fullback. Brought down at the 28-yard line. So they give it to the fullback, and he's able to get him 8 on the carry. They line up at the 28. And we've got a tie ball game here as we pause for halftime. Kicks it off. Hit and dropped at the 27-yard line. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll give it off here. He fights forward to about the 29. Westbrook gets 3 yards on the carry. The Giants line up with a nickelback. Drops back. He throws on the run. He got depleted. That pass is good for a first down.
And he had some zip on that one, didn't he? He reared back and threw that one about as hard as he could.
The offense lines up with 3 wide receivers. They'll keep it on the ground again. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. A pickup of 1 yard for the halfback. From their own 41-yard line. Westbrook lines up as the deep back, I formation. Another run. The defender gets him to the ground. He was caught with nowhere to go.
This is a pretty good running back, and if you can hem him up like that, pretty impressive.
Drops back to pass. Looks down the field. Andy just got hammered, and they couldn't have asked for better timing on the sack.
This defensive line is just so impressive. They keep manhandling this offensive line, pushing them back into the quarterback. As a quarterback now, you have no choice. You have to do some quicker plays, get that ball out of there.
He punts it. McQuarters fields it at the 24. He's tackled at about the 29-yard line. Decent return there. He'll give his offense pretty good field position.
You know, I like that return. Nothing flashy, but it was really effective. The thing I hate to see are guys that are dancing around back there trying to be a playmaker when they're really not. At least he got up the field, got a few yards. That's what I like to see.
Here's the give. He fights forward to about the 33. That's a 3-yard gain.
And that's why you send all those guys to plug up the holes. And that time there were no holes, really. And he was lucky to get anything on the play.
Come on, let's go. Let's hit him in the mouth. Come on, baby, get up.
He'll get it again. Tackled at the 37. Jacobs gets about 4 yards on the draw play. Third and three now. Ball on the 37-yard line. Manning comes to the line. Three wide formation. Hands it off. He doesn't get back to the line. The offense had a tough time picking up all their blocks on that play.
You know, you can draw up any sort of protection scheme and blocking scheme that you want. But ultimately, this game comes down to one big man against another big man, and that time the defense's big men, they won the battle.
Gets the punt away. Jackson fields it at the 26. He got everything he could, but there really wasn't much there.
Yeah, that certainly wasn't one of his best efforts there. Maybe if he would have gotten a little more help from his blockers, he could have broken one out of there. You know, sometimes it just takes one good block to create a seam to get one up the field.
Here's the halfback. And he's drilled at the 29-yard line. Westbrook comes away with 2 yards on the carry. Westbrook lines up as the deep back, I formation. Drops back to pass. Throws it. Batted away. Oh my, the quarterback is lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Yeah, you try and fit some of those into some tight holes, and every once in a while, you're going to get one pick. But that was a pretty good play by the defense.
He's looking to throw. He throws it. It's loose. Phillips grabs it up. The receiver should have held on to that one.
Wide receivers are pretty good at catching the football. They're not always good at running with the football. It takes a lot of strength to hold on to that ball, and he gave it up.
New York sends a man in motion to the left. He looks to throw on first down. Comes down with it. Brought down at the 20-yard line. And a nice pass to the tight end.
So much of the game today revolves around those substitution packages, trying to bring extra defensive backs on the field to try and help against the pass. But when you have a big receiving tight end, that really makes that plan awfully tough to execute.
Looking for an open man. And he catches it. And they get him around the 19-yard line. Not much of a gain at all on that first down completion.
Pretty tough sometimes when a quarterback is looking at his first read, it's not there. The second read is there, but he knows his guy is going to get hit immediately afterwards, and that's what happened there. They took away the first and second read.
They're going to pitch it. Dropped behind the line, and they were not able to get much there.
And so many times you hear offensive coordinators criticized because they don't try to run the football enough. Well, when you get stuffed in the backfield like that, you understand why they would rather call the pass play.
At the end of three, the scoreboard is dead even. Third down and 12 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line.
Let's go! Hey, let's make some plays now. Hey, what? Screen 88! Screen 88!
Yeah, we see that screen.
Back to throw. With a pass. Is there for the catch. He's brought down around the 12-yard line. Good game through the air, but they're still short of the first down.
Yeah, and if the receiver would have reached the ball out a little bit more, he probably would have been able to pick up the first down there. On a good gainer like that, you just can't allow yourself not to know where those chains are. Could have made that play.
He's got it. Well, that one looked like it was going wide, but it barely made it in.
That one just made it inside the upright. That's one where you see the field goal kicker going, but he got it.
Jackson has it at the 5. Drilled at the 29-yard line. Once again, we'll take this opportunity to remind you that this game is brought to you by the fine folks at EA Sports. McNabb lines up in the gun. He has three receivers in the formation. He drops back. All kinds of pressure. And it's caught. Defense pushes him out of bounds at the 48-yard line. You know, it's really easy to overlook those big guys on the line, but they did a good job picking up the blitz there.
Yeah, it's pretty tough to play a zone coverage against this quarterback. He does a great job in recognition, and that time you could see him move the zone defense just a little with his eyes before he threw it in there.
And that one will go for a first.
And really top-notch quarterbacks know how to throw a football in there without leading his receiver into trouble. That was a great throw.
McNabb hands it left. He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage. He lost some valuable yardage on that run.
And typically you can tell if a counter is going to work or not based on whether those offensive linemen are able to turn the corner and start going up the field. If the penetration hits those guys in the backfield, very seldom will the counter work.
They go with the toss. Hit and drop behind the line. Try to find something, but there wasn't anything there for him.
Yeah, not anything at all. And as a running back, you're probably going back to the huddle going, guys, a little help, please.
McNabb back to throw. Scans the field. Andy has been his go-to guy on the drive. Nice little pitch and catch with the wideout.
Patience for a wide receiver is just so key. He's able to manipulate that defense, set him up one play, come back with the exact same look, and break off of it the next. Beautifully run.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23. Ace backfield this time. Westbrook left side. And we have a flag on the play. Looked like the ref is going to call this one back.
Holding offense.
And I really didn't see the hold there.
Honestly, Tom, there is holding on every single play. I mean, the rule changes now allow for the guys to grab, but you have to keep inside the framework of the defensive player. As long as you do that, it typically doesn't get called. It did there.
There's a play fake. This pass is incomplete. And the defender breaks up the play.
Just great position that time on the defensive side. The receiver really never had a chance on that one.
The backfield is in the offset I formation. Looks to pass. Throws on the run. Struggles to find his target with that one. The tight end couldn't make the grab.
And sometimes you get used to throwing to those speedy wide receivers, and the tight ends are just a stride slower, and you saw it there.
Bobby five.
McNabb drops back to pass. Steps out at the 30. So it's fourth down. This one will be from 47 yards out. And he got plenty of distance on this one. And it's good. And that was not an easy kick, Chris.
Yeah, it looked like a little adrenaline kicked in on that one, didn't it? Maybe even surprised him how far he hit that one.
Great kick here. Hickson from the one. Still moving. He's tackled at the 27. So as the offense heads back onto the field, we'll take this time to remind you that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. If it's in the game, it's in the game. Back to pass. Goes through his read. He dives, and he's got it. That was really a remarkable catch.
And I love listening to the crowd when you see a catch like that. You go, hey! And everybody sort of in unison. They love seeing plays like that.
He drops back to pass, throws it short, and the tight end is wide open. Short completion there. That doesn't give them much in terms of yardage that time.
Well, the defense forced them to make the quick read and throw on that one. The catch was made, but there wasn't much yardage to go along with it. It's up to the receiver to make something happen on a play like that.
And they get him around the 49-yard line. 2 minutes left in the ball game. Third and six, ball on their own 49. The Giants come out in a shotgun set. They motion to the right. Drops back to pass. Passes it out. Can't hang on. Tumert was the intended target on that incomplete pass attempt. It's fourth down. Looks like they're going to put it away here. Jackson awaiting the return. Punts it. Down in the end zone for a touchback. And they will get the ball back with just under 2 minutes left.
This game has now gotten to the point where every single play will matter. One mistake by any of the 22 players out there on the field, it could mean the game. Boy, this has been exciting to watch.
On play action, passes it. It's intercepted to the 20. He's brought down at about the 13-yard line. So they give up the big interception. Now they have to buckle down on defense and stop them from scoring.
Whoa, this game feels a little differently now, doesn't it? All of a sudden, the momentum has completely shifted to the other side of the ball. Let's see what they can do with it now.
They line up at the 14. Manning comes to the line under center. They'll come out in the single back formation. They give it to the tailback. He fights forward to about the 13. They picked up a yard.
Well, that was the perfect time for them to call a blitz. They got in there, filled up all the gaps, brought down the running back for a short gain.
The Eagles take a timeout, and that was their first timeout. The halfback with the carry. He's tackled at the 11. Gain of 2, and so it'll be third down. They line up on the 10. The Eagles bring in their dime package. Brought down behind the line. Cornerback did a nice job recognizing the play and getting in there for the stop.
For me, there's nothing more impressive in football than to see a cover quarterback able to come up and make the stops on the run. That's a complete football player.
Not much doubt as he puts that one right through the upright. He kicks it off. gathered at the 6. Brought down at the 37. Down 3, under 2 minutes to go. It doesn't get much more exciting than this.
Well, there's really no other way to put it. The game is on the quarterback's shoulders at this point, and the first down is always the most difficult to get. Once you get that one, a lot of times the momentum really gets on your side.
What a play by the defender.
And the quarterback really caught a break on that one, that wasn't intercepted.
Westbrook lines up as the lone back. 3 receivers split out wide. Looking to throw. Under heavy pressure. Tipped pass and picked off. It's a fumble. They fall on it. That was a huge turnover.
What a tremendous play by the defense. You really began to get the feeling this offense was getting something going. They strip the football out of there and kill the drive, kill the momentum.
A close call there. Was it a fumble?
I don't know why you keep asking me. You know every time it goes to replay, I'm basically wrong. So I'm not going to guess anymore. I'm just going to wait and listen with everybody else.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is overturned.
What a saving play. They'll reverse the call on this fumble.
You know, it's just not easy to see when the runner is down. And that time, the officials took their time, able to take a second look, and they got it right.
Jacobs gets the carry. He's dropped for a loss. It looked as if the offensive line just collapsed on that play.
And it looked like this defensive line just beat him off the snap. Sometimes those guys can time out the quarterback's cadence. And if the quarterback doesn't start changing that snap count, his offensive line is going to really struggle.
They take a knee. 3rd and 12. Ball on the 39-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And there's the whistle. Our final score is the Giants 9, the Eagles 6.